What is anxiety? Anxiety is fear, oppression, or a sense of impending danger. It is often marked by vague physical symptoms such as tension, restlessness, and rapid heart rate. An anxiety disorder is one of the group of recognized mental illness involving anxiety reaction in response to stress. What is agitation? Agitation is an inappropriate verbal, vocal, or motor activity due to cause other than disorientation or real need. Medication and medical condition can cause anxiety such as pregnancy, Alzheimer's disease, any heart rate issues, and hypothyroidism, glycosemia, stimulant use, medication withdrawal, urinary tract infections, hormone changes. Don't dismiss their fears. Don't pressure the patient. Don't leave the patient alone. Also, never grab hold or even gently restrain a patient. What you can do is to ensure the safety of the patient is staff and other in the area. Be directive, empathic, understand what they are going through, and speak calmly. Help the patient manage and regain control of the behavior. Attempt to identify and eliminate stress. Do not argue with or confront the patient. Make an environment safe. Monitor the patient activity. Suggest patient is at risk of injury. Notify the nurse promptly if the patient wander away from the unit facility or home. Assign the patient brief tasks or engage the patient in activity that enhance self-esteem. Use beanbag seats and rocking chair in the long-term care facility or the patient home. Watch for injuries. Prevent the patient from becoming exhausted. Some patients might also complain about heart palpitation or chest pain, hot or cold flashes or sweating, shortness of breath or hyperventilation, numbness or tingling sensation, dizziness or feeling faint, frequent urination or diarrhea, nausea, muscle tension or headaches, tremor, twitching or shaking, fatigue. So your vital signs are good. So tell me what's going on with you. You can't breathe. You are sweating and shaking. Okay, so I can help you. You are not gonna die even though it feels that you are. So okay, look at me. Look at me. And it seems that you might have some anxiety. So has it happened before? Okay, so are you reacting to what's going on right now or to something else? You don't know. Okay, it's okay. I understand. So what I want you to do is now take a few deep breaths and try to relax and follow me as what I'm doing now. So I'm gonna count to one and two, and then we take a few deep breaths and then we release. Okay, one, two, inhale, and then release. One, two, inhale, and then release. One, two, inhale, and then release. Okay, so you seems better now. So what about your chest pain? So you don't feel any chest pain now, okay? So if this happens again, I want you to repeat this exercise as we did now. So are you worried about something like your surgery tomorrow about the inguinal hernia? So you don't have to worry about that. It's a small surgery and everything will be fine before you know it, okay? So thank you. If you need any help again, so call me. We have with us a 70 kg conscious selective case of inguinal hernia, a woman with makeup jewelry and contact lenses. So ma'am, I want you to what I want to do now is please take your jewelry off and straight if you can yourself. Okay. I'm going to wash off your makeup with a warm water cloth. Make sure the water is warm when you soak the cloth. We're done with it. After an anxiety attack, teach the patient way to measure their anxiety. Breathing exercises, muscle relaxation, or self-soothing visualization can help. Communicate with the physician about the anxiety attack. Follow up with a reassure and encourage the patient to seek help from discharge. A panic attack can occur even though there is no trigger present. Patient can become distressed or frightened by the attack, or see him or her as a real person, not a disorder. A panic attack on its own is not life-threatening. Patient need reassurance, compassion, and someone to help them through it.